10.
You know what? Seriously? You come and you interrupt my meal, you won't eat with me. This is bullshit. This is supreme bullshit.
Is it okay if I come a little closer? Is that okay?
You take one more step, I'll shoot you. That's all I'm gonna say.
Marshall, I want to tell you something important.
Use it or throw it away.
Sit here a sec, catch my breath.
Got an ambulance on the way.
That'll be nice.
I warned you twice.
I guess I'm one of those guys who don't believe you when you tell them the stove's hot.
I was in Nicaragua a while back looking for this money launderer named Roland Pike. The cartel's gun thug, Tommy Bucks, looking for him too. Bucks got me. Took my gun and put me in a car with some other man. Drove us to some old coconut plantation. Then he tied the man to a palm tree and asked me where Roland was. I told him what I knew. No sense in lying. I guess he wasn't certain he could believe me, needed to be sure, or he just wanted to impress upon me how serious he was. But I watched his Tommy Bucks stuck a stick of dynamite in that poor man's mouth, taped it so he couldn't spit it out, lit the fuse. Next time I saw Tommy Bucks in Miami, I told him he's got 24 hours to get out of town or I'm gonna kill him.
And you?
Yeah. But he pulled first, so I was justified. But what troubles me is what if he had? What if he just sat there and let the clock run out? Would I have killed him anyway? No, I wanted to. Guess I just never thought of myself as an angry man.
Raylan. You do a good job of hiding it, and I suppose most folks don't see it, but honestly, you're the angriest man I have ever known.
And I don't care if he's a quadriplegic. Hell, I don't care if he's just a torso on a skateboard, my man.
Whoa, what the hell?
Don't move, don't move. Now, you're gonna do everything I say, or I'm gonna jab this needle in your neck, I'm gonna depress the plunger, I'm gonna shoot you full of drain cleaner, and you're gonna die.
You gotta be
careful. Okay.
All right, open the door,
okay.
Open the door.
Okay.
Okay, get in.
Okay.
Put the seat back.
Okay.
Put it back faster.
This is as fast as it goes, okay?
All right. Open your mouth. Just open your mouth. Go, it's easy. Good. Now, you think I'm a real jerk off, right? It's rhetorical. Shut up. You think because I have a shabby little office that I'm a loser? I'm a man, Mr. Ferguson. I help people. I take care of them in exchange for tamales and hot sauce. Now, in order to pay for that, assholes like you get the upsell, the bonding, the laser whitening, the gold, not porcelain crowns. Now you say you don't want to pay? You don't want to pay me? You know what? It's all right. But I'm going to take back what's mine. Open your mouth. I'm going to stab you in the throat. You can consider me a repo man, all right? Open wide. Okay, halfway done. Good job. Real wide. A little bit more wide. You can rinse now.
shoulder my way to the front of the line.
I didn't say that. You did.
Look, I understand I'm the little man on the totem pole. I understand that. But Raleigh and I have a long history, and I should be walking point.
This isn't just about this case. You did cut to the front of the line. And I don't know if it's because you know the chief from Glencoe, but you walked in and you went right to the front.
Yeah. You ever consider I happen to be good at the job?
And you being a tall, good-looking white man with a shitload of swagger? That has nothing to do with it? You get away with just about anything.
What do I get away with?
Look in the mirror. How'd you think it'd go over if I came into work one day wearing a cowboy hat? You think I'd get away with that?
You want to try it on?
Are you cold standing out here?
Not really. Why?
Because I can't keep from staring at your nipples.
You're Givens.
I am.
You shot Tommy Bucks. Tell me, did you really tell me at 24 hours to get out of town and you'd shoot him on sight?
Something like that.
That's fantastic. I read what Bucks did to that poor Nicaraguan farmer with a stick of dynamite. Jesus Christ. I mean, you must have really wanted to shoot the guy. I know I didn't. I just read a report.
UNA USA?
Yep.
Guys still haven't figured out how to put a dead man on trial yet, huh?
Believe me, we'd love to. Yank Carnes out of the morgue, you know, wire him up like Weekend at Bernie's, get a ventriloquist to speak for him. I plead not guilty, Your Honor. But you got all these negative Nancys always quoting the Constitution and his goddamn due process bullshit.
My collection. My father grew up in Germany, in Munich, before the war. He was very poor. He saw the wealthy of his city, and he wanted what they had. But there was no way someone like him could ever hope to rise to that. And then along came a very charismatic man who knew who was to blame. And my father followed him. Publicly, after the war, my father recanted everything the Reich stood for. But he never did in his heart. In private, after some wine, he would say that his years working for Hitler were the best of his life. His proudest achievement was when Hitler selected him to run a team that went through the country, reacquiring the Führer's old paintings. I hated my father. So this has been my project. I buy Hitler's shitty paintings, and I burn them. Do you understand?
Deer that bows hunting, it's open season wherever the bluegrass grows. You might not pursue it past the state line.
Mike, I need you to check my trigger. Sometimes it just goes off on its own.
Helen, come on now.
Helen, maybe you could point that gun somewhere else.
Of course. Goodbye, Johnny.
Hey, tell Raylan I said hey.
You used to be somebody. Not anymore.
Well, I've tapped into a power greater than you will ever know, my friend.
Stop running that drag out
both sides.
And you
repent your sins and beg the Lord for forgiveness.
Would.
Upstairs and not down.
You know the rule. Get away. Men of God are not to be touched by anyone.
Snitching.
Now, you don't really have any idea what he's doing now, do you? I know I don't. Now listen up. His heavenly Father will take care of him when his time comes. But if his time comes early on account of any of you, His father here on Earth is gonna see to it you are gutted like trout.
But truth is, you're short in the gate in a few months. What do you think's gonna happen to him then, huh?
Why don't you take a shot and find out?
Don't you push me, Book Runner!
Take a shot.
You watch it, old man.
Son, what the hell are you doing?
It's good to see you, Daddy.
She's my daughter.
And where is she?
I don't know, with her mother, I guess.
When was the last time you saw her?
When she was 3. Most beautiful little girl in the world.
How old is she now?
15, I guess.
Would you like to see her?
Could you do that?
Well, we could try.
You could bring her here to me? Well, Marshall, that'd be a miracle. It'd be a real miracle considering she don't exist. The Simone on my chest, that's David Simone. He was an enforcer for the Wizards MC. I killed him. He was my first. That's why I hold him dear to my heart. But I don't got no kids. At least none that I know of. Hell, I wouldn't give a shit even if I did.
Hey, give me 24 pieces of spices you got.
We're closed.
All right, I'm a deputy U.S. Marshal ordering you to get me some chicken.
I shut down the
broiler.
That's the last order for delivery.
I'll take it.
Like hell you will.
I'm officially requisitioning this chicken. If this doesn't pay for it, send an invoice to the courthouse.
But what'll I tell the customer?
You tell them the U.S. Marshal Service is grateful for their patriotism. Now, here we go. Check this out, Walls. What do we got? 24 pieces extra spicy.
24 pieces extra spicy.
It looks like some greens and some cornbread. We'll get some bourbon.
You didn't say shit about bourbon.
It's an arts office. And, how is it?
Probably got tranquilizers ground up in it.
Well, I hope not.
Gentlemen, I'm sorry to interrupt.
We'll just keep it down a little bit.
Why would we do that?
Because I didn't order assholes with my whiskey.
What'd you say?
Any woman who is merciful enough to allow you into her bed deserves better than to be insulted behind her back. So why don't you stop trying so hard to impress your friend? Drink your drink, and we'll be just fine.
You seem to be harboring a bit of hostility there, brother.
So I've been told. Tell me what Duffy has planned.
Oh, Jesus Christ!
Now.
We was gonna take her.
What do you mean?
In case Gary didn't show up with the money, we was gonna kidnap the missus, use her to force Gary's hand.
When?
Ah, son of a...
Billy, the next one is for you.
Tonight. I'm supposed to have her over at Duffy's in an hour, but he said he wanted me to stop off and pick up some trash bags.
Trash bags? What the hell for?
Duffy's crazy.
You know what, Billy Mac? Just because you can't box and you're stupid don't mean you gotta end up dead.
You strike at the shepherd, that the sheep may scatter.
You strike at the shepherd, that the sheep may scatter.
You strike at the shepherd, that the sheep may scatter.
They strike at the shepherd, that the sheep may scatter.
You might strike out the shepherd, but us sheep, we won't never get struck out or scattered.
Or words to that effect.
Would you do me a favor? Just show me in there where it justifies the killing of innocent people. You really don't know shit about the Heavenly Father, do you, Crowder? It's assholes like you that give Christians like me a bad name. No, Frank, I got this. You want to talk about the hand of righteousness? You're going to find out what that means.
Never should have come down. It's too many rules.
What kind of rules?
Oh, all kinds, hell. I can't even remember them all. They're from the Bible.
They kick you out for breaking one of God's rules?
Yeah, one of them. One lousy rule, he kicked me out.
Well, what'd you do? Lie, steal, dance on Sunday?
He called me an onanist. Bet you don't even know what that is, smartass.
Actually, I do.
Yeah, well, I didn't. How do you think that was, boy, running me down in front of everybody?
I don't know. Funny?
You go to hell.
Just playing. So he kicked you out for jacking off, huh? Hey, Dewey Crow, you stop right there.
My second month in Vietnam, the squad leader leads us into an ambush. Half the squad gets killed, the others captured. I dove into a bush. Can't explain how, but Charlie never saw me. I could have kept fighting, but we were overrun and outnumbered, so I hunkered down, held my breath, and watched as they carried away my best friend. Tennessee boy, we call Blue. As the past, Blue looked over and saw me hiding. I wanted to look away after we made eye contact. I was so ashamed, but Blue's stare held me. Then the strangest thing happened. Blue smiled. Not a day goes by that I don't see that smile. You know what I think? I think maybe he was smiling because I got away. Just like I think the name Lucky was given to you because it's a blessing, not a curse.
Why me? Why do I get to live?
What do I look like? Some kind of holy man? I can't answer that shit. The only answer I got is another question. Why not you? You know that story was bullshit, right?
I figured. It's a good story, though. Worked.
Yeah. Pretty good. Remember your mama's laugh?
She had a good one.
She always hoped you and me would get closer. Maybe things would be different now if we had.
Yeah, I guess that ain't our way.
You should get married again. Not living like this.
What's going on, Arlo? Keep checking your watch.
Just wondered how long I've been a prisoner here.
That all, huh?
That's it.
We never had much in common, you and me, but that doesn't mean I don't have regrets.
Put the gun down. When are they coming?
They're waiting outside. How long you known?
Well, Arlo, in truth, I think I've always known.
You didn't happen to bring your rocket launcher, did you?
I didn't think to pack one.
All we want is Raylan Givens!
I'm Raylan Givens!
No, I'm Raylan Givens!
He trying to be funny.
A little.
We get Givens, the other two can walk.
I ain't going anywhere. They killed my daddy.
You came here to kill your daddy yourself.
Well, that's different.
How?
You got to kill the two men who came after your daddy. You give me the same courtesy.
I'm pretty sure you're empty.
You gonna bet your life on that?
No, Raylan, I'm gonna bet my life on you being the only friend I have left in this world.
In the deep, dark hills of eastern Kentucky, that's the place where I trace my bloodline. And it's there I read on a hillside gravestone, you will never.